so far being in this town, if I've learned one thing, it's like everybody and trust no one.
Feel the rain on your skin. No one else can feel it for you. Only you can let it in. No one else, no one else can speak the words on your lips. Drench yourself in words unspoken. Live your life with arms wide open. Today is where your book begins.
Boys and girls, if you would like to interact with this presentation, when you see this, that means to pause the DVD and get on your computer, go to www.google.com and type in the phrase that appears on your screen.
From headquarters here in New York City, you are watching King 4 News, bringing you the best coverage in news, events, weather, and sports. Reporting with a special broadcast, here is John Hughes.
I'm so fed up with my job and having to report propaganda off the newswire that I've decided to do my own report today.
Imagine this. Yeah, here you are in America, and they're combining America, Canada, and Mexico into one country. The North American Union, and the American people don't know anything about it. It's not even in the press. They'd rather talk about Rosie O'Donnell and Donald Trump calling each other names.
Rosie is a loser.
Than discussing the fact that we're merging into one country.
Most of America is caught in the propaganda. Everything you see on TV is filtered and paid for by corporations.
I mean, the fact of the matter happens to be that tells you how controlled the media is. Here you are combining America, Canada, and Mexico into one country, and you don't see it in the press.
These scenes of unrest in America have never been seen before. Cameramen would shoot them, but newsreels wouldn't play them. Controlling the news started early in America.
It's a mediaopoly, a mediaopoly. The whole media is controlled by a few corporations, thanks to deregulation by the FCC.
Disney, Fox, Westinghouse, and good old GE?
They own networks from CBS to CNBC.
They can use them to say whatever they please and put down the opinions of anyone who disagrees.
The American people are living in a matrix. They don't understand the truth of how things are working in this country. You know, and let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. The very fact is that if you ask 100 people on the street what kind of government is America supposed to be? 99% of them will tell you a democracy. America is supposed to be a democracy. But that's a lie. That's an illusion. The word democracy is not written into the Constitution at one time. It's not in the Bill of Rights. It's not in the Declaration of Independence. The Founding Fathers hated the idea of a democracy. They thought it was the worst form of government there is. And I agree with them, because in a democracy, 51% of the people control 49% of the people. If you're part of the 49%, you're not free. America was founded as a constitutional republic. And in that constitutional republic that we have, 99% of the people can't take away the rights of 1%. You have your rights because you were born with them. You have God-given human rights that nobody can take away from you. The government, the majority, no matter who they are, I can't take away your rights.
Our freedoms are being taken away by power-hungry bankers.
Bankers?
Yeah. Our country was hijacked by elite bankers in 1913 when the Federal Reserve took over our monetary system.
Did the creation of the Federal Reserve represent a takeover of the United States by shadowy international financiers? Certainly, the Fed was designed to serve somebody's interest, but whose?
And now you have this Federal Reserve system, which then in 1913 got the right to create money for the government, when before that the government created its own money. Now the government, when it needed money, had to borrow it from this private bank called the Federal Reserve, which is a private bank owned by individuals incorporated in Delaware.
Well, the Federal Reserve is neither federal in his doubtful reserves. You will not find the Federal Reserve in the blue pages of government in any phone book. You will find it in the business pages next to Federal Express.
The Federal Reserve System solely is responsible for creating money in the United States. The Treasury prints only what the Federal Reserve tells it to print. The far greater amount of checkbook money is also determined by this group. Yet it is not a government agency. and is entirely beyond the reach of the American voter.
Since the Federal Reserve has come into being in 1913, illegally, without a constitutional amendment, by bribing a few senators during Christmas vacation, they turned over the most important power that the American government has, the creation and issuance of money, to a private bank. Through that private bank issuing money, they have destroyed this country. They have destroyed the purchasing power of the money in this country. They've created social programs that are destroying this country. Now, they've taken over our government, both Republicans and Democrats. There's no difference anymore between the two parties. They control both parties.
If you have the money, you can get any law passed you want. So who do you care? Whether Bill Clinton is president or who is senator from New Jersey, it doesn't make any difference because you write a check and you get another senator.
Forget the politicians. They're an irrelevant. The politicians are put there to give you the idea that you have freedom of choice. You don't. You have no choice. You have owners. They own you. They own everything. They own all the important land. They own and control the corporations. They've long since bought and paid for the Senate, the Congress, the state houses, the city halls. They got the judges in their back pockets. And they own all the big media news, all the big media companies, so they control just about all of the news and information you get to hear. They got you by the balls because they own this fucking place. It's a big club, and you ain't in it. You and I are not in the big club. By the way, it's the same big club they use to beat you over the head with all day long, where they tell you what to believe all day long, beating you over the head in their media, telling you what to believe, what to think, and what to buy. The table is tilted, folks. The game is rigged, and nobody seems to notice. Nobody seems to care. Good, honest, hardworking people, white collar, blue collar, doesn't matter what color shirt you have on. Good, honest, hardworking people continue. These are people of modest means. Continue to elect these rich who don't give a fuck about them. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't give a fuck about you. They don't care about you at all.
We have been getting an overwhelming response to our Showbiz Tonight's question of the day. Charlie Sheen speaks out. Do you agree with his assertion that there is a government cover-up of 9/11? Let's take a look at how the vote is going so far. 82% of you say yes. Only 18% of you say no.
I'm here in New York City where there is word out that some people actually believe that the U.S. government has not been honest about the terror attacks on September the 11th. I've decided to be a journalist today and actually ask what people on the street think. Sir, are you aware that our own government may be guilty for causing the terror attacks of September 11th and giving us a reason to invade of foreign countries? You catch the game last night? I mean, the evidence seems to be coming out from all directions. Our country may be killing innocent women and children for their own selfish gain. They're saying that Joe Montana is the best quarterback ever, but then you gotta know there's Tom Brady.
9/11 was done by people in our own government and our own banking system to perpetuate the fear of the American people into subordinating themselves to anything the government wants them to do.
But what is the best way to sell big government and then world government to a people like ours, historically devoted to an independent republic of limited powers? The answer is simple. In revolutionary literature, the tactic is known as pressure from above and below. Deliberately create problems, and then offer only those solutions that result in the expansion of government. Create conditions so frightful at home and abroad that the abandonment of personal liberties and national sovereignty will appear as a reasonable price for a return to domestic tranquility and world peace.
Sir, do you believe that the U.S. government orchestrated the terror attacks of September the 11th?
That is an awful thing to say about our country. I'm going to tell you one thing, and that is I support my president, and I personally know that he had nothing to do with the events of September 11th. America was attacked that day.